Hi everyone. So in this video, we are going to talk about important aspect, which is event bubbling and event capturing. So what happens when you click on one button? So you have HTML page, and when you click on one button, so there are a lot of things are happening when you click on target element. Event bubbling also happens. Event capturing also happens. Event bubbling is something when you click on some particular button in a table or anywhere, the one particular event bubbles up to the parent to the window object. Event capturing happens that one particular event will trigger down from the window object to the document till that target element. So whenever it is coming down, that is called as a event capturing capture phase. Whenever it is going up from the target element, that is called event bubbling. So we sometimes do event.stop propagation, event.prevent default, stop propagation when we do not want event to propagate further to the upper DOM elements and do something, because there might be some event. So consider that on TD you have an on click event, on T body or some body also you have an on click event. If this event bubbles up, then you might get into situations where the unnecessary on event is getting triggered on multiple DOM nodes. So what we do is, whenever we click on submit button of a form, we do event dot stop propagation, so the event will not propagate from that button to the form element to the body, right? Whatever you wanted to do, you capture the data and process with that. So there are advantages and disadvantages. Most of the time we actually deals with the stop propagations and event bubbling only. Bubble phase, which actually bubbles up in upward directions from the DOM node to the document window object. Okay, event capturing which will go downwards till from document window to the target element. Okay, so there are some advantages also to have this event bubbling, which is called event delegation. So the question, they will not ask you what is event bubbling, event capturing and all these things. What is event delegation? Consider in one particular scenario, you have this kind of scenario where you have a UL tag and there are multiple, and you don't want to add an on click event on each and every. So here also you did on click just to know which element I have clicked on. If you do this, if you have like n number of li elements, then you have to do it for each and every li. Instead of this, what you can do is, you don't do on click here, just don't define it. You allow user to click on li and handle the on click event on the UL node, and here based on the target event.target property or some identifier, I will be able to know which li element has been clicked on, and then based on that I will handle the event here. I will do the stop propagation so it will not go to a body or your document or window. Okay, because here I will do a stop propagation, I will stop it. Okay, so this is called event delegation. You are delegating your event to the parent node, so you don't need to handle on each and every child node and the parent node. Here you can see app.eventListener. This can be a UL also by ID. So let's say tag. Here we have ID. I'm just defining it, which is a tag. Okay, so what we are doing is document.getElementById. So here we are doing document.getElementById tag and listening to this click event. So even if you click on to the li, right? So from the event.target name, if this click happened from the li and this event is coming from there, you can get the item and you can actually get the inner HTML or any particular property of that item to identify, okay, I clicked on this li or that li. Okay, that is called event delegation. That is important aspect of general JavaScript. And event bubbling, event capturing, stopping the event propagation, or how to stop the event from propagation, or how to use the event bubbling feature to solve our problems. Okay, thanks everyone.